Consider the zip file. It's the archive format we all know and use. And most of the time, we make zip files by way of a utility. But that's not always efficient or practical. In this video, we're going to look at how Python gives you native tools to work with zip files. Python's standard library features the zipfile module, and with it you can create new zip files, open most existing ones, we'll go into the limits of that later, and do pretty much everything that you would do with a zip file. Add files, remove them, extract them, and use different kinds of compression with them. So let's take a look at a simple example. I have here a short Python program to work with zip files, and next to it is a README that we will use as one of a couple of things to insert into an archive. To create a new empty zip file, we use the zipfile object, like this. It's a little like creating a file generally in Python with the open command, since we also supply an access mode. In this case, it's W for writing to the file, and that creates a new one if it doesn't exist. We can also supply a compression type for the zip file. The default with zip files is no compression. Everything is stored as is, much as it would be in a tar format file. Here, though, I'm using the basic zip compression type, which is deflate. Others are available, but deflate is the most broadly compatible. To write an existing file into the archive, we use the zipfile object that we created and its write method. We pass in a path to the file we want to write, and we can optionally supply a path inside the archive to write the file to. But right now, we're just going to write this file to the root of the archive. And the file can be anything, text or binary, we don't need to specify. We can also take a string and write it directly into the zip archive as a text file. And here we have a string, and we use write string to write it into the archive. Notice that the first argument is a path for a file that we're going to place this stuff in inside the zip file, and we're supplying a subdirectory there. We don't have to create subdirectories inside the zip file manually. We can just provide a full path like this, and any subdirectories needed to create the file will also be created. I mentioned the with block works as it does with files in Python generally, meaning that once you exit this block, the zip file is closed and all its changes are finalized. That's important, because if you don't use a with block, you're going to have to close the zip file manually, otherwise changes may not be synced back to the zip file. This next with block reopens the zip file, this time in the default read mode, and we can read out files directly from it if we know the path, or we can iterate through the files in it using the infolist method, which gets us a list of all of the files in it. So when we come across a file that matches a certain file name, we can use the extract method to write it out somewhere outside the archive. An important thing to understand about extract: if the file inside the archive is in a subdirectory, extracting it will by default attempt to place it in a matching subdirectory in the current working directory. Here's what I mean by this. I'm going to run this code, and now I'm going to use a zipfile tool to open the created archive. You'll see in there we have the README file, which we placed in there, and we also have a subdirectory named info. And in there, we have the file that we created using our string data. Now we've extracted this file as well outside the archive, so let's look at the directory outside the zip file. You'll see we now have a new directory called info, and in it we have the string data text file. When we extracted that file from the archive, by default, it recreated the directory structure the file already existed in. We could have also passed a path for the file just to be extracted directly into, but this behavior is really useful. It lets us extract the contents of an archive in a way that mirrors its placement inside the archive. One more thing worth mentioning is what kinds of zip files you can work with using zipfile. And the documentation for zipfile runs down some of these limitations. This module does not currently handle multi-disk zip files. It can handle zip files that use the ZIP64 extensions, that is, zip files more than 4 gigs in size. It supports decryption of encrypted files in zip archives, but it currently cannot create an encrypted file. Decryption is extremely slow, as it is implemented in native Python rather than C. So if you're using Python and you want to create an encrypted zip file, for instance, to send to a client from an API endpoint, you'll need another approach. One example would be to use subprocess.run to invoke a command line archiving tool, and that could let you create encrypted archives. One example of such a tool would be the 7-zip utility. So to sum up, Python's native zip file library lets you create, modify, and examine zip archives. You get a lot of control over the results, including the compression type and how files can be added and removed. But if you're working with encrypted archives, you're going to need to use an external app from Python. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and infoworld.com.